Namaskar children. Let us learn few definitions that we have earlier explained. So first is HTML element. What is this HTML element? You can see HTML written within tags. I told you before, you start as you start the writing the HTML code, the first code or the first tag that marks the beginning of the HTML code is this HTML written within the angular bracket. Now this HTML is a container element, that is it has got both the beginning and the end with backslash in before writing HTML. So this is the first element in HTML document, which defines document as an HTML file. So as soon as you write this HTML within the angular brackets in Notepad, it defines that it is an HTML document and not just a text file, hence the extension .html that we write later on. So an HTML element contains two other tags, head and body. Head contains the title of the page that your web page that you're creating, and body is the design that you view on the web page. So head element, the head element includes the identification and additional information about the HTML document, such as title and the keywords. It is also a container element because if you remember, head have got both opening tag and closing tag that has got a backslash before you write head. Title element, the title element is a container element that provides a title to a web page, and title of the element is generally written within the head element. The title of the web page is displayed in the title bar of the web browser window. Title bar of the browser window. If you can recall the video that earlier, the just beginning of the video or beginning before I did this video, the previous one, if you remember, I showed you how the title of the web page is observed or is viewed in the title bar of the browser window. So it is enclosed, the title element is enclosed within the head element of the HTML document. And also the title of the web page can contain up to 64 characters. More than 64 characters or letters you cannot write in the title element, because it is just the title of the page and it need not be a big description. So it is within 64 characters. Body element, the body element has a it begins with the tag body tag. It is the main content of the web page, that is the page that you view on the web browser. It includes text, image, table, links. As we shall study further, we will get how to include these things. It is a container element, that is it has got both opening tag body and backslash body, that is the closing tag. And it appears just before backslash HTML. So backslash body, it is just before the HTML element. So HTML element within HTML tags, the body tag is included. The body element has many attributes that can be used to specify the background image. Now if you remember, this is the tag, and to describe a tag we use many attributes. So body element has also got many attributes in order to describe the body element, like the background image or color of the web page, left margin, top margin of the web page, alignment of the text that you write on the web page. So these things are described by the attributes of the body tag. So let us learn the first attribute of body tag, that is the background attribute. As you can see, the tag is body. The attribute is background. After putting equal to, the value starts. In the value portion, you have to put the URL or path of the file name, that is the background picture that you want to insert. That picture's path or file name has to be written, either the name of the picture you have to write, that's the file name, or the path, that is where the picture is, like in the desktop or in the D drive. What is the path exact, the path name you have to write within the quotes. You can see that the file name of the picture that you are inserting as the background has to be written within quotes. After you've written, then you can write the other content of the web page, and of course you have to end with the backslash body so that the picture is visible as the background, right? So if you see the code HTML, then within that is head and title, then you've closed the head over here, then begins the body. In the body, they have used the attribute as a background, and over here they have given the complete path of the image. It's a GIF image, background .gif, and it is stored in HTML folder, which is again in see dry. So this is the complete path of the picture that you are that you want to see as the background. So then there is the backslash body, you end it, and then you end it with a HTML backslash HTML. So this completes the entire code that you will see that the background image will be visible. Now suppose instead of using background image, if I want to if you want to insert a background color, that also is possible, but in that case we will use the attribute BG color. Over there the attribute for background image was background body background after, and after giving space after body, and over here it is writing, you are writing BG color is the attribute to put any color as the background, and after writing that you have to put a equal to sign and write the color that you want to insert. Now this is hashtag RRGGBB. This is a representation of the color in hexadecimal number. You can also represent color by writing the name or else the hexadecimal number for the color. The next attribute of body tag is text attribute. Text attribute is used to specify the color for the text in the web page. Throughout the web page, what color you want to write in, that color you can select by using the text attribute for the, again for that body. So text color of the web page by default is black. If you do not mention any text attribute because you don't want any specific color, then the default color is black. But if you want to specify any other colors, then you have to write, use this text attribute body space text equals to within the quotes, you have to write the color that you want. Either the color, you will write the name of the color, or else you can write the hexadecimal number for the color. The last attribute for the body tag that we will learn is left margin and top margin attribute for putting the left margin in the web page and the top margin in the web page. For that, again top body then space left margin, give the value, say whatever 50, 80, whatever space you want to keep to the left, the space. For that you give the left margin, it can be anything that you want, from 10 to any other number, from 0 to any numbers. And top margin, again for this space you will write the top margin equals to, give the value. Over here you will see you are seeing the value they have given is 80 for the left margin, and top margin they have left 70 points. Now this value is generally measured in points, like in maths, like you use in centimeter, meter, etc. For computer it is either points or pixels, so it is written in points. It's 80 points or 70 points, that's for your general knowledge I'm telling you. So this is how you give the top margin and left margin by using these two attributes. So children, in this video we have learned about the body tag and the different attributes used in the body tag, like the background, BG color, left margin, top margin, text. Please underline the things where I have also underlined, and in the next video we will do the practical for this particular body tag. Okay children, please study. Till then, Namah Shivaya.